Hello and welcome to an overview of the DSpace community. This video is part of a series of training videos about DSpace and its community. Several key groups make up what we call the DSpace community. In this video, we will provide you with an overview of these groups and explain how they interact with each other. If you would like to learn more about DSpace, its history or distribution, or have technical questions about the software, please visit our website at dspace.org. Let's get started. The DSpace community is first and foremost made up of its users. What are DSpace users? Simply put, they are institutions or individuals at institutions that use the DSpace software. The most common institutions that use DSpace are universities, libraries, or government agencies. The global DSpace community counts thousands of users from institutions all over the world, a vibrant and engaged community of developers, repository managers, and decision makers. At times, several institutions from a specific country, region, or language join together to form a user group. Within such user groups, institutions share information about ongoing activities, projects, events, or experiences with DSpace. Some user groups also organize yearly meetings. Currently, the DSpace community has over 20 national user groups around the globe. Institutions that use DSpace can also decide to become DSpace members. Member institutions commit themselves to supporting DSpace financially. Since DSpace is open source and free to use, membership is critical to ensure the sustainability of DSpace. DSpace membership is available at different levels or tiers. If you are interested in learning more about becoming a DSpace member, please visit our website at dspace.org/membership. Some institutions join DSpace as individual members, others as part of a group of institutions called a consortium. Since consortia are usually organized by country, they often support the activities of their respective national user group. One benefit of DSpace membership is the opportunity to serve on governance. DSpace governance sets the strategic direction for the DSpace software and consists of the leadership group and the steering group. The steering group meets monthly, is more involved in the day-to-day operations of the DSpace program, and makes recommendations to the leadership group. The leadership group, which meets quarterly, approves the overall priorities and strategic direction of the DSpace program. The volunteer team that manages the code within DSpace and recommends the technical roadmap to DSpace governance is called the DSpace committers. This small group of highly skilled professionals is nominated from within the community. They review community code contributions and address security issues or major bugs. They thereby review the work that is done by the DSpace developers community. Developers are volunteers from all over the world that implement the technical roadmap set by DSpace governance and the committers. They do so by contributing code suggestions, changes, and new software features. Did you know that anyone is welcome to contribute to DSpace as a volunteer developer? If you would like to get involved, please visit our website at dspace.org and learn more about how you can help with development work around DSpace. Some volunteers in the DSpace developer community and the committers group come from our registered service providers. These are companies that provide services for DSpace users, such as hosting, maintaining, and customizing DSpace repositories. Did you know? In addition to member institutions, registered service providers also support DSpace financially, and service providers with the largest contributions serve on DSpace governance. Another important part of the DSpace community is the DSpace Community Advisory Team, in short, DCAT. This group meets monthly and is mainly comprised of those who work with DSpace repositories at their institutions, such as repository managers or system administrators. One important role of DCAT is the support of the development community in testing new releases of the DSpace software. DCAT also retains a non-voting seat on the DSpace Leadership Group and shares feedback from the DSpace community. Here's the amazing thing about the DSpace community. Every institution and group mentioned so far is comprised of volunteers. They support DSpace because they want to contribute to the sustainability and long-term operability of the DSpace program, and we truly appreciate their dedication, commitment, and contributions. Without them, DSpace could not exist. A small team of non-volunteer program staff interacts with all groups discussed in this video. This team consists of the DSpace Technical Lead, the Global Outreach Manager, and the DSpace Program Coordinator. All of them are funded by DSpace membership contributions, but employed by Lyrisys, the organizational home of DSpace. As the organizational home, Lyrisys provides much of the infrastructure needed for operating the DSpace program. It also retains one non-voting seat on DSpace governance. That's it! You now have an overview of the different parts of the DSpace community and how they work together to make DSpace the thriving and vibrant open source program that it is today. In the next video, we are going to explore how you can get involved. If you would like to find out more about DSpace and its community in the meantime, please visit our website at dspace.org.